Good morning from Mount Cook, which is New Zealand's highest mountain. It sits at about 3,700 meters or 12,200 feet, depending on if you do imperial or metric. I pretty much do neither and both at the same time.
Same. Thankfully, though, we're not going to actually try and climb this mountain. Instead, there are multiple walking trails that you can take. So we're going to do a couple of those today, starting with the 10-kilometer Hooker Valley Track.
Have fueled up and we're feeling about half human again. We've driven 10 minutes down the road to Tasman Glacier Viewpoint.
I thought, based on the fact that this was only intended to be a half hour there and back, that this would be relatively leisurely. But then we started driving up and then I realized just how steep it looks. So this could be fun. We made it to the top and it said it would take 15 minutes to get up, and it has, and thankfully the stairs that are there were not as bad as I anticipated. The view's lovely.
The view's absolutely lovely. This is Tasman Glacier, and it's actually the largest glacier in the entire country. It is 23.5 kilometers. Unlike the ones we saw in Franz Josef, this one is 600 meters deep at its maximum. The other one was only 300 meters deep, so this is double the depth, which is crazy in my mind. Just stopped at the supermarket to pick up dinner on the way to our Airbnb, and we kind of realized that we haven't been shown ourselves eating since we got to Australia. And it's not because we're starving ourselves, it's just because we haven't really been going out to eat when we're in more expensive countries, as much as we wish we could, because all of the food here in the restaurants and cafes are just so appealing, but it's not in our budget.
We tend to cycle through a few kind of staple meals, so we figured we would take you on a grocery trip with us so that we can show you exactly what we do eat when we're in countries like this.
Let's go grocery shopping.
First off, bananas.
I'm a big dude, I need a lot of food. Therefore, this works out perfectly as a dinner for the pair of us. Great option for breakfast.
We discovered these in Australia and they are an absolute gold mine. Got so many flavors and they are wonderful. Our favorites include the likes of this one, so we're definitely taking a box of these.
We usually get the cheapest bread because it's just so versatile. It goes with
peanut butter. Any non-Brits who haven't tried beans on toast, you're missing out. And finally, hummus, as with pretty much everything.
And that'll last us about half a week.
Now that that's all done though, it's time to head to our Airbnb.
Wish we were staying here longer. This place is huge and it's so nice.
The spread that they've got for breakfast is nothing short of amazing. Even though we're going to only be spending just over 12 hours here, it's going to be a very nice 12 hours indeed.
And just for reference, I think this place was $88, whereas the place that we started at this morning, which you will have seen, was $170. I guess it's all location.
Sure is. But that is going to be us for the day. So we are going to really, really take advantage of everything on offer here. And we will catch up with you at our next destination in New Zealand. So until next time, take care.
And keep smiling.
So we figured that we would take you right on.
Beans. Any non-Brits who haven't tried beans?